Now, a good question you may ask me now goes as follows. So suppose you were given a completely positive map and you check that this map is invertible. So it's satisfy the conditions for invertibility that we discuss. And then you work hard to design encoding and recovery channel for this particular map E. The question is this construction custom made for this particular completely positive map? Meaning, if I change this map, do you have to go back to the drawing board and design new encoding and new recovery channel? It is actually a quite important question, right? Because usually this map E is induced by the environment, and we do not know exactly what the environment is doing. Of course, we have some idea, but we are never completely sure. Now, the good news is not the case that it's really custom made for this one completely positive map. If you look at the condition for the recovery, something that we actually discussed some time ago, the condition says that when we have a fixed recovery channel and it has Krauss representation, so the Krauss operators associated with the recovery channel, and the errors or the Krauss operators associated with this completely positive map, EI. The recovery condition says that the product of the two has to be proportional to the identity, where the identity refers to the identity on the code space. The good thing is that if this particular map composed of this Krauss operator or this set of errors is invertible by this recovery channel, then so is another completely positive map, such that the Krauss operators of this new completely positive map are in the span of operators EI. So you look at the set of errors that the circuit can correct, and then you take a linear span of those errors. So any, call it a new error, say, DJ. So any map with those errors can be also corrected or inverted by the same circuit. So just to be more specific, so you know that this one is invertible, right? So you design the circuit for this particular map, it has errors EI. And then consider another completely positive map with a Krauss operator's DJ, such that DJ is in the span of EI. Remember that those operators form a linear vector space. They can be added, right? More than that, you can define Hilbert-Schmidt product, and this turns this vector space into Hilbert space. So coming back to this point here, so if the new Krauss operators associated with this new map are in the span of original errors EI, then of course DJ, every single DJ, can be written as a linear combination of errors EI. And then if you then look at this condition here and check whether it satisfies for errors DJ, then you can easily see that that is indeed satisfied. So the product of RK with DJ, you substitute for DJ this expression here, and you can see that this product here is also proportional to the identity being the identity on the code space. So if you want, you can just put the projector operator here and sandwich this expression here with two projectors on the code space. So that's a good news. So the message is, when we design a scheme with encoding and recovery circuit to correct for a certain class of errors, then then the good news is that given this set of errors, we can also look at the linear span and of those errors and everything that is in the linear span, any new error that is in this linear span of errors EI is also correctable. So that's a good thing, and we already saw that we can design circuits that correct for Pauli errors, at least on a single qubit. Pauli errors defined by the Pauli operators, so that by the Pauli operator I will mean now n-fold tensor product of any of the Pauli operators. So if I have n qubits, the Pauli error on qubits will be given by the Pauli operator, which is a n-fold tensor product of any sequence of the Pauli operators. So that kind of Pauli operators are very convenient because they are Hermitian, and they are also unitary, and they have all kind of interesting mathematical properties. One of them is that they form a nice basis in the set of operators acting on n qubits. And so we are going to explore the mathematical structure of those Pauli operators and to have a little bit more insight about constructing quantum error correcting codes.